Well, weekly yard maintenance. It's about that time. Get out here and mow this bad boy. Look at this bad spot right here. The other day at the birthday party, this was home plate. And you can see at one other spot right there, that's the pitcher's mound. There's a little spot at third, first, and second. We had, I don't know, 30 people out here playing wiffle ball. Boy, that spot got pounded right there. And now you know kind of the real reasoning behind Kentucky bluegrass back here is we kind of have neighborhood wiffle ball games and things like that. All the kids, adults come over. And so I want you to imagine, picture it with me. Home plate is right here. Of course, the neighbor's fence is left field. The arborvitae over there is right field. And then, of course, center field is my building. And we're going to kind of create a little wiffle ball type area here. So that's going to be pretty cool. And back here in the back, I'm still at 1 day a week on my watering. And it's holding up pretty good. I'm just gonna get set up right here and catch this corner. Actually, I had to split it up into 2 days because of my schedule. I watered the large portion in the front yesterday and then got up early before church this morning and come out here on the end and set it up down there and let it run for about 3 hours before church. And now it's after church and we've eaten lunch and I need a nap. My belly's full, you know how it goes. And so while I'm mowing the grass today, I'm gonna go on and set out this sprinkler and let it catch this corner right here. I kind of split the yard up into different sections back here to get it watered. And typically, yes, this area back here that, you know, I call the test plot area, fescue out here, Kentucky blue and some other fescues over there. Yes, I do mow this the same day that I mow my yard. And it's a little different now because we're super hot, super dry, and the fescue, you know, is stressing a little bit. So I don't want to mow it to death. That's always been one of my big cultural practices during the summer. I'd rather spend my time watering than mowing, simply because, you know, I can mow it whenever. I can let it grow. I can let it get a little tall, a little bushy, a little shaggy to protect the ground, protect the turf, conserve as much color as I can. You know, I get more out of the watering than I do the mowing. So I really limit my mowing back here when it gets hot and dry. So I'm not going to be mowing this today. This is going on about day number 9, roughly, since I've mowed it. So it's been about 9 days since I mowed this back here. And depending on if it rains or not, it could possibly be another 5 to 7 days before I actually get out here and mow this part. Again, I'm in super protection mode back here. Hey there, it's Pete with GCI Turf. Hope you're having a great day today. I want to welcome you out here to my home. It's about the first week of June. Incredibly hot. Now I'm telling you, it's pretty hot right now. This right here is pretty much the cool blue, fescue bluegrass mix. My yard is irrigated. I'm watering it about 3 days a week, roughly. Doing a little bit of syringing here and there, and it is hanging in there really good. So I'm basically running the elite edition to my lawn care guide, which is basically the full blown, go all out. Anything and everything you can do to a yard within reason. And this is kind of what you get. I've been asked a whole lot of times, Pete, what's kind of like your routine maintenance on your yard? And I don't think I've ever did a video on this, and it's something super simple. You know, it's something I do all the time. I do it every single week, every time I mow. I kind of have this repetitious order or this systematic order in how I approach doing my yard as far as mowing and edging and trimming and all that goes. So I'm just going to take you through all that step by step, show you what to do, and maybe it'll help you in some way, shape, form, or fashion.
And I always start off by doing all my weed eating and trim work. And when I originally designed this yard, I designed it with minimal weed eater and trim work, meaning there isn't any, except for the one road sign out in the corner of the lot. And obviously, by state law, I cannot remove it, but if I could, I would. So I edge my beds out on a bi-weekly basis, meaning every other time that I cut the grass, I'll edge the beds. And no, this isn't using the machine that cuts the big groove or nothing like this. This is more of a maintenance style edging, which creates a nice, clean, crisp, defined line between my pine needles and my turf. Now, the reason I edge the beds first is because every now and then I'm going to kick up a little pine needles and throw some debris out in the yard and that kind of thing. And by doing that first, when I go back and mow after that, the mower just kind of grinds up any of the material and disintegrates it, and it's pretty much gone. Now, once I get all my beds edged, it's on to the main event of the day. Yes, sirree, boy, that's the mowing. That's my favorite part of the maintenance. That's where I get to use my creativity and come up with different striping patterns and that kind of thing. And I haven't really used my big league lawn roller any this year. Honestly, I haven't had time to mount it to the mower. It won't be long, I'll get that thing mounted up, probably before my July 4th mowing. That way I can really make those stripes pop. Now, I've still got a great working relationship with Big League Lawns, and I've got that same coupon code where you can get a discount on it if you want. I'll link that up in the description below for something you're interested in. My height of cut right now is 4 1/4 inches. And because I'd let it go about 7 days in between mowings this time, it was a little bushy and a little shaggy. So I went on and double cut it and cut the old traditional checkerboard pattern. The double cut really today was simply to, you know, kind of really clean up the yard really good, simply because I'd let it go a pretty good while in between mowings. And once I get done with my mowing, I grab my stick edger, and I've got one little small area of sidewalk right in front of the house that I'll stick edge. Now, we've got asphalt in our community for a road, and where the grass meets the asphalt, I like to keep that edge nice and tight as well. So I actually use the stick edger to do that. Now, I kind of separate edging the asphalt area versus my sidewalk. I keep the asphalt area on the same schedule as I do with my bed, so it gets done every other week as well. I do stick edge the sidewalk weekly every time I mow, unless I just feel like it needs a break, and then I simply don't do it. And once I get all my beds edged and then get everything mowed up nice and tight and all my stick edging is done, I'll go and get everything blown off. Now, I really feel like this is one of the most important parts of the entire job, simply because I want to leave it spick and span clean. I want the road so clean I can eat off of it. And the way I do it here is I'll blow the entire road off, all the way from my yard, all the way over to the neighbor's grass, all the way around the corner, the entire block, the entire area. I will make sure it is spotless clean. And when I do it this way, yes, I do get some grass clippings up in my neighbor's driveway. Actually, three of my neighbor's driveway. And out of simple, basic respect for my neighbors, I'll walk up in their driveway and blow their driveway off for them. Because after all, those are my grass clippings I blew over there. And of course, everything around the house that's a hard surface, including my patio back here in the back, I'll blow it off nice and clean. So once I get done blowing, the property is as clean as I can physically get it. It is spotless clean from one end of it all the way to the other. And before I throw in the towel, I'll make a lap around the house and I'll hand pull any weeds that are too close to plants to where I'd be scared about any Roundup getting on them from drift. Or if I have any plants that have weeds growing up in them, I'll hand pull that out. Now here I've got this unique weed. It's kind of like a thistle, and I get quite a few of them in my beds, and they are loaded with thorns, and I honestly don't like pulling them with my hand. So if I can't get them with my backpack sprayer and the Roundup, I use my little foam applicator. And this thing is absolutely awesome because I can micro target the individual plant. Even if it's growing up inside a desired plant, I can still apply this to the weed and smoke off the weed and not harm the plant I want to keep. Just be real careful. Don't get this on anything you want to keep because it will kill it. And then I grab my backpack sprayer, go around, spray all my cracks in my concrete, and you know, if any weeds come up in the patio, I'll spray those. Walk around my beds in the pine needles, spray the weeds that I didn't hand pull, make sure I'm really good and thorough, and guess what? I'm done. And of course, then I get to sit back and relax and enjoy the fruits of my labor. Sit back on the patio, chilling out, having a sun drop, hanging out with the wife, kids, chilling. Man, I really enjoy taking care of my yard. I love doing my yard work. I love getting out in the yard. I love the release from work, the release from everything in the world. I put my headphones on. It's just me and Jesus and then more. And I can just mow and relax and chill. And I absolutely love it. That's kind of what my weekly yard maintenance looks like. And not necessarily weekly, but when I mow the yard. And springtime, that's going to be roughly every 3 days, maybe 4 days. You know, when it's growing a little aggressively. You know, when it warms up and gets in summertime, gets hot, that turns into every 5 to 7 days I'll cut it. Now, actually, this time it's been about 9 days roughly. And like I said earlier, on the test plot, it's non-irrigated. And if it gets watered, it's because I manually water it. I like to go into protection mode when it gets hot and dry back there and really limit the mowing as much as possible. And even though my yard is irrigated, I kind of do the same thing, but you know, I kind of scale it back a little bit. So, you know, I may actually let this go 10 days without mowing it and continue my normal watering schedule, the whole nine yards, let it get bushy and shaggy. And I've noticed over the years when I let the turf relax a little bit in the heat and let it get bushy and let it get, you know, dense and thick and a little tall and a little shaggy, man, it just holds out so much better during the summertime. And yeah, I know there's folks out there that cannot tolerate a bushy yard. It has to be tightly clean cut 100% of the time, but that's just not me. You know, I'm about the health of the turf. And you know, to be completely honest with you, it gives me a break. I mean, you've heard me talk about this 100 times. I love mowing grass. I love mowing my yard. I love striping it. I love maintaining it. I love everything about taking care of my property. But at the end of the day, you know, you do that over and over and over, you get tired. You mean you physically get tired. And letting the yard go for, you know, 7 to 10, 12 days, you know, it actually gives you a little bit of a break from mowing, especially when it's hot. And hey, there's nothing wrong with that, right? Old Glory's flying high and proud right now. And we're not too far from July 4th, where, you know, we kind of celebrate our country's freedom. Big day. Man, I absolutely love that day. We're going to have a cookout here with a lot of people here. And the way I'm going to prepare the yard is I'm going to allow the yard to relax, like I was talking about earlier. Not mow it a whole lot up until that day. And about 2 weeks before that, I'm going to go ahead and put down my summer fert. I know in the guide, you know, it's a July 4th application, but we should have the 600 with that 14% iron. Remember last fall when my yard was just incredibly off the chain dark green? Well, that's what I used, that 600 with that 14% iron, and it darkened the yard up like nothing I've ever seen before.
So I want the yard to kind of be in that condition when I have this cookout and everybody over. So I'm going to get the 600 down about 2 weeks before July 4th. It should be in stock any day now. So keep an eye on the website and it'll be there for you. And if you're following the cool season guide and you know that goes down July 4th, if you want to get that down a little early, that's completely fine. Ain't going to hurt a thing. And then I'll mow it probably on July the 2nd-ish, somewhere around in there. Edge everything out, clean it up, make sure all my weeds are cleaned up. And that way everything's really spick and span for the big cookout. Can't wait for it. Hey, as always, I appreciate you taking time out of your day to watch. I'm going to go finish this sun drop. I'll check you later.